This is Dr. Benway, Undercover Radio. I just wanted to tail this show. I had nothing to do with it, but I wanted to say this is right up my alley. And it's just great stuff. I mean, everybody knows that the government is all fucked up right now. And there's only one way it's going to be fixed. It's from the bottom up. It's never going to come from the top down. If you think the next election is going to solve anything, I think you're a little bit mistaken. The government is completely screwed up structurally. Everybody's out for themselves. They're out for their own self-preservation. And at this point, I think it's, you know, revolution can come in many ways. And one thing is for sure, it comes from the bottom up. You know, it doesn't necessarily mean taking up arms or anything like that. But it does mean people taking action and making change. Change that'll improve things that have gone just too far off the deep end. And I just wanted to play a little piece from my last show while I'm at it. You know, I was at the shooting range the other day, and I started thinking about the rights we have in the United States. When you think about it, it's pretty amazing what our forefathers came up with in our U.S. Bill of Rights and in our Constitution. The Second Amendment says that we have the right to keep and bear arms. We have the right to bear arms for personal security and the right to bear arms to defend our country. We even have the right to bear arms to defend against a corrupt government. That's a pretty amazing thing in a world where many countries are ruled by dictatorships or supported by an army that exists to protect the government from its citizens. But I guess you already know these freedoms are eroding as time goes by. For example, many people today seem to think there's no place for firearms in our society. So many people I talk to wonder why on earth anyone would own a weapon, especially in this day and age. Yes, this day and age where governments are collapsing all around us. Even our own government has become a self-serving lawmaking machine, all with the supposed premise of protecting us from ourselves. Seems like our rights are slowly but surely disappearing. Our personal freedoms are vanishing before our eyes.
After its discovery, the government quickly clamped down on all those free radio stations that started popping up, and they created the Federal Communications Commission to regulate who could use the airwaves and what they could say. Now you tell me, how free is that? You know, these days the government only seems to exist to put more laws and regulations on the books. Did you know the U.S. passes an average of 300 new laws a year? 300. We have thousands of laws on the books and thousands more to come. And now we have our almighty Homeland Security Department out to protect us from the world. It sends chills down my spine. Oh, don't get me wrong. I think our government's fundamental responsibility is to protect our national security. more to protect our national security than we realize. But part of the price for this protection is the loss of some of our personal freedom and privacy. Trust me, it won't be long before the government knows where we are at just about any time. Police cars and toll booths are currently equipped with license plate scanners. They're hooked into instant background checks. And what about our brave new digital world? A digital world that has given us such wonderful new smartphones with built-in GPSs that allow tracking of our every move. And I mean every move. The chips in those phones are so accurate now they can detect what floor of a house you're on. Your email is logged and stored in our wondrous cloud. Most likely, many of our conversations are filed in some data warehouse somewhere. They're all digital. All this information is most likely being collected and analyzed for anything that might be a danger to our national security. But take it out a few years. 10, 20 years. All this data might be analyzed for anything improper. Or maybe even immoral. And you thought you were safe from 1984. Freedom is a funny thing. I suppose total freedom would be equated to anarchy. But do we really want anarchy? Some people living in the clouds claim anarchy is the answer. But then I have to ask them how things are going in Somalia. It's human nature for someone to be a leader and others to be followers. Freedom is some sort of balancing act. You and I both know that we have to have some rules in place to have a civil society. It's human nature. It's always been that way. Leaders and followers. It's just human nature. But for those who follow, please don't confuse us with apathy. Apathy is probably the most destructive obstacle to freedom. Please think about the balancing act required for freedom. The price of freedom is eternal vigilance. We must not allow the scales to tip too far off balance. I'm sure you already think that things have tipped over the edge. We've used America up and sold it out. If you feel that way, don't just sit there sulking. Get off your ass and do something about it. Yeah, I know you've heard all this before, and you'll hear it again. But we're all a nation of apathy, and my friend, this is a dangerous thing. Our apathy is quickly paving a nice little path to tyranny. We're all lemmings being led to the usual path of destruction, just like all civilizations before ours. Is it really inevitable? Recollections. Memories. Memories of William Cooper yelling on the shortwave, telling people to wake up. Flashbacks of reading old issues of Comedy, Tragedy, and Apathy, the Journal of the Apathy Generation. Memories of shortwave evangelists predicting the end of the world. Flashbacks of the horrific Indian Ocean tsunami with waves over 100 feet high. Laughing at Harry Shearer's Le Show. Listening to pirates crackle over the airwaves. Hearing Alan Wiener rant on about real pirates. Does any of this really matter anyway? We're all doomed. Doomed to be hit by an asteroid. Doomed to die in a nuclear winter in the aftermath of a supervolcano. Doomed to be erased by the next ice age. We're doomed to become hordes of hideous zombies as a virus infects our brains.
Sir, did you want to order something?
Oh, yes, I'm sorry. I'd like a double Whopper with cheese, extra large fries, and a 64-ounce Coke.
Well, fall back!
hope you don't mind me tailing your show, WPON. I just thought it was kind of appropriate. Thanks tons for that show, because it's right up my alley. You know, I do a lot of shows about surreal things, but sometimes it's time to get a little bit serious because things are really starting to go in the shitter, and they're heading downhill quick. The only way things are going to change is through us, from the bottom up. The government is never going to fix itself. You know it's never going to fix itself. Not going to happen. Elections coming up in November, forget about it. You know it's not going to change a thing. Everybody's out there for themselves. This is Dr. Benway, Undercover Radio. Thanks, WPON, for the excellent show tonight. Anybody who would like to send me an email, you can send me an email at undercoverradio@gmail.com. And have a good night, everybody.